Why is the world not at peace? Because everyone starts from their self-interest, thinking from them, from their own interest, the expense of others. If everyone thinks like that, self-interest as number one, then how can we have a peaceful world, have a world of harmony? Because of self-attachment, we have hatred because you do not follow me or follow my desires, or you have greed, I want, I wish, I love. So the attachment to self is the cause of all this misery. Going against me, I hate. Something I like, it's greed. And ego brings out that arrogance as well. I above others, I'm above others, stuff like that. I must, everything's I. So Buddha start from, you know, open the surgery on the ego. This is what how Buddha treat this problem. We have to break through the illusion of self. Without true wisdom, without true effort, even you learn from Mahayana Buddhism, there is no effect on us. There's no achievement in our cultivation. Because the pollution is there, the ego is still there. Everything you do was tainted by that perspective. So no matter what we did, we'll be tainted by it, by the ego, and we'll end up creating not a good karma. So our life becomes miserable. Person who start from ego, a nation cannot be at peace. A person who full of ego cannot have a united family, united nations. Even in an organization like Dharma Place, you will not be brought up to the good point if everyone's egoistic. So Buddha advised us, if we can take our eye out of the way whenever we are doing stuff or thinking stuff, speaking stuff, when we're planning stuff, we always think about others, then eventually everything gets better. If you only think about, or if you think more about benefiting others, less about myself, then you're getting closer to that happy life. I met a householder, a lay Buddhist. I asked him, you have a very good material life. Everything you eat, sleep, everything is there. I asked him, you also take a lot of time. This is an old lady who serves the community every day in the temple. I asked him, do you feel tired, fatigue? This old lady say, no, I don't feel fatigue at all. I feel more energetic. As the more I do, the more energy I have. I feel the bigger, the world is bigger. On the other hand, people who has everything, but they only think from themselves, their own perspective, rather than benefit others. Anything, any little triggers, any little, wrong tone, brush you the wrong way, then they all, it becomes like, bickering, ranting, whining. Everything comes from hatred because it touches the ego. Therefore, if we remove the selfishness, we will gain true benefits. With that, we will attain right awakening. So we understand that right awakening has a standard to measure against. It's not a title you can give to anyone. So why do we start from right awakening? A person with this level of cultivation, they have let go of the ego and the selfishness, the idea of me comes first. Do you understand that? Do you understand?
明白吗?
No, Venerable wants to ask, how do you speak, do you understand the English? So, if we understand, then we should take it seriously and start aiming for right awakening. So how do we attain right awakening? We need to let go of our selfishness, purify our heart from all this selfishness, narrowness. With one side, you're letting go of this, the other side, recovering from, you're recovering your compassion, your broad-mindedness. So these are the brief introduction on first level of Buddhist cultivation. In right awakening, to define right awakening, lack of selfishness, absence of selfishness, absence of ego. So, using that standard, if we look in ourselves, if we have desire for fame, prestige, lust and all that, still have that in there, then we have not attained right awakening. Everything that satisfied yourself. Now, we're moving to the second level, right? Because when we learn Buddhism, we need to go to the highest, gradually. So, number two is Samyak, somebody. So, equally perfect enlightenment. This is like a master level in our university qualification. So, from bachelor degree to master. So, master is, in Buddhism, is equally perfect enlightenment. Equal to what? At this level, we are equal to Buddha in terms of, if we achieve this level, it's equal, your level of enlightenment, awakening is the same as Buddha. You have not attained the Buddhahood, you have not taken the Buddhahood, but attained the Buddhahood, but you only, but your understanding and your awakening and everything is already the same level as Buddha. So you see what Buddha sees. So what does it mean? We should continue next week because the time has passed. I would like to summarize it. There's a lot more actually that follows about this equally perfect enlightenment. Not only you need to attain right awakening, which is somebody, you need to attain equally perfect enlightenment, which is Samyak somebody. How do you get Samyak somebody? Do you believe in yourself? Do you have confidence in achieving it? Don't stuck at arahant. You want to be a Buddha. Don't stop in the first level. You want to be equal to Amitabha Buddha, to Sakyamuni Buddha. You should have this. Buddha encouraged that. You should. This is what differs Buddhism from other religion. No one can become God. In Buddhism, everyone encouraged to be Buddha. First, you need to believe in yourself. As long as you have the vow, you have the will and the persistence, you will achieve that. Obviously, during the process, you need to give out the cost equivalent to the level of attainment you achieve. You need to pay the price. What kind of price? Price of your ego. That means you need to be patient. You need to take in the test in everyday life. Because without test, tribulation of life, you never know how far you have reached. How much you can take in, how much you can resolve. No matter what you see, what you hear, what you touch, what you eat, what you think, you must be patient. Let it go. If you have done to a level where you do not give rise to a single thought, congratulations. good, you have attained the level of Buddhahood.